just a few seconds to go. It's Paraguay in the red with the serve. Australia in blue on serve receive. And first point goes to Australia, courtesy of Tequila Clancy, who hammers that one down. Easy leave. Still a few nerves for Paraguay. This is the biggest competition they will have ever played in. Nice shot. It's not about how high you can jump or how hard you can hit. It's finding the spaces on court, and that's exactly what Paraguay did. Filippo now with the serve. And unfortunately, Valiente couldn't keep that one in play. Easy swing for Borden, the lefty going cross court. But there was a net touch in the process, so Paraguay had the ball. This time the job is done successfully from Borden, and Australia have the point. Good scramble, nice play by Clancy to get that back into a position where Borden could have a swing. Boy, I'm recognising that fact. Good up. And a great shot to the line. Australia establishing themselves early in this set. Good to see that pick up from Clancy and then put away. First end change then, Australia with their noses in front. They've had a decent season so far this year, and they've actually been on the podium at Poreč at the major series, where they finished third, seeded 22nd, picked up 640 points, $32,000 for that. Good read from Clancy. Oh, good pick-up. Nice play by Valiente, but it won't come back in play as Filippo snatches at that one. Really good pick-up by the youngster, but to no avail in the end. Always going to be Australia favourites. They're showing that now they're on court. Well, that was an opportunity wasted though. Nice little pokey from Valiente. Getting instructions from Clancy. He's going to block. He's coming through to the net to try and do that. opportunity. Clancy went after it. Seemed to stumble. That's a good serve. Nice play from the youngster. Especially played on the World Tour has Valiente, 37th in Stay of Wonky in 2013. $1,700 in prize money. So that would have made her, what, just 15 years of age when she played on the tour. The first time. Moment though, it's Australia who are bossing this one. Nice swing from Borden. Oh, good angle. Well, certainly, she may well be the younger of the two players by 10 years over Filippo, but she's certainly got more experience and has got more shots at the moment. Nice big net touch from Australia, and that was good from the referee. Just waiting. It was a close call as to who touched the net first. But a massive touch, wasn't it, from Borden, and no real danger. Paraguay getting the point, and they're all square. Oh, good effort that. Having to react as the ball clipped the net. But Paraguay could go in front here. Good chase from Clancy, stays in play. Better opportunity now for Australia. They can't convert. Valiente. Oh, that was unlucky. Right choice to go cross court. That was where the space was. But not the accuracy needed to get the ball in play. This is really good from Borden. High on the ball the whole time. And keeps it off the sand. And that hard work paid dividends in the end, with Paraguay making the error. The handle. Well, Paraguay not overawed by the situation they find themselves in at a World Championship for the first time under the spotlight here in The Hague. Line block signalled. But an easy point for Australia. Good angle. Well, Paraguay coming up with the shots. Australia at the moment just struggling to contain it all. Interesting. A little pokey from Valiente, going with a non-dominant hand. Great swing. Well, that's what Australia have that Paraguay don't, is that height and power at the net. And put it to good use with that play. Pollock. Yeah. some of the moments captured by the super slow-mo camera. Borden with the serve. No, oh, it's a great serve. Oh, drop really quickly. Valiente not ready. Good touch, Clancy guessing. They've made a decent block. Then wasn't really sure what to do next as it came up, breaking and loads of space for Valiente to put it away. Double touch called against Clancy. Still off balance, still moving. That's better from Australia. Great view from there, isn't it? Oh, that was unlucky, just missing that baseline. It was close, but no cigar. Good swing. Well, it favours Louise Borden on that side, with being the lefty, opens up the angles for her to go cross-court, and being left-handed, she could also swing on the line from here, and able then to use the block to her advantage. Nice serve. Good defense. A bit tight to the net, though. Borden's all over it. Mismatch exploited. Oh dear, it's gone against Australia. Must have been a net touch. Tried to disguise it with a celebration. There's no disguising it from the referees. So Paraguay have the point. Just two behind. Make that one behind. With the help of the net, they get themselves a touch dace. All smiles at the moment. So difficult to play when it does that. Great blocking. Well, Borden had her hand up to say she was being screened. Paraguay didn't even move. And now we're all square. Blocker at the net's not allowed to stop the visibility of the server behind her for the team that are looking to side out. And the timeout called by Australia. This is brilliant for Paraguay, leading 16-14. Good serve. Well, that was unlucky. Gordon got up, didn't know where Clancy was, and ended up blocking her from getting to the ball. This youngster is playing with absolutely no fear at all. Bit of a mix-up for Australia. Oh, big block. Excellent play. Gabriella Filippo shutting down Louise Borden big time. Excellent work from Paraguay. Australia get the ball back, but now, as far as Paraguay are concerned, it's pretty simple, isn't it? Keep siding out, and they can side their way out to taking this first set. If you want to get involved on Twitter, that's where you can do it. Hashtag FIVB World Champs. Join the volleyball community here at The Hague if you can't get here and watch. And you want to support one of the teams, something to say, we'd love to hear you. So Paraguay get their side out. This is bonus time now. If they can get something from serve, they may well do. Well, that's better though. Borden over the top of the block. Easy line for Borden to put that ball down. Oh, that's a cheap point. So now Paraguay have set point. Well, this definitely wasn't on the cards for Australia coming into this game. Well, it was a serve to nothing, really, for Valiente. She could go up and hit it as hard as she wanted to, because it's all about this opportunity now. Still set point. They've got three chances to get it down from side out. Clancy has to come up with something from the serving line to put Paraguay under pressure. Valiente for the set. Oh, she's done it. A belt across court, and Paraguay open their account here at this World Championships with one set in the bag, 21-17. Lovely swing, cross court. Boom. These two will be buzzing right now, won't they? Australia going to do? Well, find out after these highlights. We go then with the second set. Paraguay with the serve. It's a must-win set for Australia, and that's the perfect start for them. Good up. Chance for 2-0. Taken. That's better. That's more like what everyone was expecting when Australia walked out onto the sand for the first set. But they allow Paraguay to play. So far, not allowing them to do that. Too close to the block. That's the price Paraguay paid. Good communication from Australia and a great point. Ball and talking to Clancy all the way through that. Communication is key in team sport. Nice disguise. Filippo cutting that one across, Borden. Clancy was already off and running. Just about perfect, deep to the middle. Well, it's taken them a set to get going, but now they are going. They're already racing away from Paraguay. Down by five, and now at the bad end, as it were, with the sun directly into their faces. The ball will be a bit of a shadow, which makes it difficult to know how fast it's coming at you and how close it is to you. Great block from Borden.
It was improper request, you start. You serve.
Tom Pevic is saying no, it's not a timeout. So it's Australia's serve. Second referee actually is a comedian when he's not refereeing. Let's split them up though. Nice work. Well, there's no answer is there at the moment for Paraguay, and now they call the timeout. That's a belter from Clancy. No stopping that one. What a turnaround we've seen in this second set. And it's looking very likely we're going to a decider. Hard to see Australia capitulating from this lead. Good power. It was a little bit tight to the net. It's an interesting tactic they're using, but Clancy doesn't seem that comfortable with the reverse set. She put Borden under a bit of pressure with that one. She got called for a double touch the last time she played it. But Borden gets Australia out of trouble, off the block and out. 7-point lead now for the team in blue. Good hustle. Paraguay working hard, but for no reward. Needs to come over, and it comes over with interest. Paraguay are under the cosh now. It's hard to believe Paraguay were able to take that first set, wasn't it? But they did. And actually, do you know what? As a team, they're so far behind now that they can just play without any worry. Not be concerned. Conserve energy, really, and say, OK, well, let's go for it. Let's go for the decider. See if we can put some pressure on. Valiente has that ability from her serve. It caused trouble for Australia in the first set. It's not working so well in the second. Australia making it look rather routine now. They just don't want to let Paraguay back in and build any rhythm, that's for sure, ahead of this deciding set, which 14-5 up, you expect Australia to go on and take and force the race to 15. Well, the communication's still good, and they're backing it up with their actions as well. Unforced errors are at an absolute minimum at the moment for Australia, and Paraguay can't deal with it. Timeout called. Paraguay taking a breather. Yeah. couple of those creeping in for Australia from the serve. As it goes at the net with the attacking, no such trouble. Well, it's a completely different team we're witnessing, isn't it, in this second set? 3 points away now from sealing the deal here. They've hustled on every ball. They've converted, put the ball into transition, and taken their opportunities. Caught the line. Break shot from Paraguay despite the call of out. Valiente gets it in. That one though was a mile wide. So set point then for Australia. Question of if, but when they take this second set. Good leave. One side out required. And even from the bad end, I expect Australia to be able to do that without any trouble. A cheap point given to them. Australia take the second set with ease. That means we're going into a decider. Let's have a look at the highlights then from this enthralling match so far. Paraguay think it's in, Australia think it's out, and the Lions judge and referee agree. So Australia have the first point of the deciding set. And the second point. Borden with a big block, and pressure is now on Paraguay right from the word go in this decider. De Liente with nowhere to go. Well, it looks like, doesn't it, that Paraguay's first set was all they had. Nothing left in the tank. And Australia keep the points ticking over. 4-0 now, Paraguay surely. Won't let this continue much longer without calling timeout. Otherwise, the set's going to be done and this match will be over in the blink of an eye. Hey! Ace serve, 5-0. And Australia have taken a firm grip on this match now. Nobody wanted it. Chase and a decent effort from Paraguay, but again it's another point for Australia, and now Paraguay call the timeout. 6-0 down, and the dream of maybe getting a victory looks to be well and truly thwarted, doesn't it? Australia have just gone up several gears and Paraguay have not been able to compete as much time as they can. They need a side out here, they need a point. Falling apart for Paraguay. All the shots that they had in the first set have disappeared. Australia are in complete control. That's a good break. And a great finish. 8-0. Surely this can't go all the way to 15, can it? Paraguay need a side out. They must get a side out. Australia, though, not allowing it for the moment. And still, they can't find a way through. Bowden puts up the wall. 9-0. Free ball for Australia. Clancy says, no need to go over on three. I can handle this. And at 10-0. This game is pretty much all over. Well, there's a difference in fitness levels. That's became evident as this game has gone on. Get involved on Twitter. Hashtag FIVB World Champs. Oh, that looked to be going out. Valiente decided to play it. It goes down as an ace. For Clancy, it's 11-0. Well, we'll be going into the archives to find out, but I don't think there's ever been a 15-0 in a tiebreaker. Not at a World Championships. and there still isn't. A big roar for Paraguay as they have their first point, and it's all ones on the board. It's the fight back on. Not as far as Australia are concerned. Another point for them. Three away now from victory. Yeah! Two away from victory. From Borden, match point for Australia. Oh, they got their act together in set two. 21-8. And it's a class act here in set three at 14-1. And it's all over. Borden puts it down and Australia take the match. Two sets to one. Credit to Paraguay for taking the opener. But it was all Australia after that. And despite the blip, Australia win the match. In convincing fashion as well in that second two sets, 21-8, 15-1. That was a thumping. Panic over then for Australia. This is how it was done. Borden's got a great float serve. Good touch from Clancy. And then on the free ball over, Borden said, yep, it's all me. And the teamwork paid off in the end. Valiente couldn't stop it from coming over. Well, they'll be pleased with that performance in the second two sets. As you can see, the statistics for the match. But we now can have a look at the highlights from the match. Well, congratulations then to our winners. Tim Simmons is down on centre court and he's hoping to have a word with Clancy and Borden. Let's see what they have to say.
Luis, that had to be the screwiest match I think ever. You lose the first set, they play near perfect. And what did you turn it around in the second set with?
I think T did a really good job of just getting the team back on track and really reconnecting with our game style and our game plan. We just needed to be a whole lot tighter and a whole lot more aggressive. So that's what we came out to do in the second set, and it paid off.
Luica, it looks like you missed your wake-up call this morning.
No, well, I think we just got to enjoy it. Like, it's such a good atmosphere here and a really good setup, and I didn't think we took the time to really enjoy it together, and we came out strong after the second set, so that's all we need to do, really.
What do you think?
Two sets, one. Yeah.
What are you going to do tomorrow?
Tomorrow we have a game first up, actually, so at 10:30 we'll be taking on Slovakia, so it'll be just recovery and right back into it tomorrow morning, and I'm really glad to get the first win done and dusted, and I'm excited to get back out there with T tomorrow morning.
Well, congratulations.
Thanks very much, Tim. Thank you.
Congratulations indeed.
Okay.
A worthy performance in the end from Australia, and they're up again tomorrow. That concludes our coverage from Game 3. Still three more to come today. We hope you can join us for those. But for now, though, from all of us here, it's time to say goodbye.